Beaucoup d'hôtels ici, hein?
Beaucoup d'hôtels.
Oui, là, c'est un hôtel. accident là-bas au mont.
Can you introduce yourself?
Hello, my name is Elise Kala and I'm a visual artist.
Hein? Elle a l'âge de mes filles.
I like this wall.
You know, the Palais de Justice.
So beautiful. This is my hotel.
Mila.
Alors le coup de foudre, je veux juste avoir une petite histoire du coup de foudre.
Écoutez, j'adore la position, le marché, et aussi de la tristesse. Hein. De la tristesse, j'adore. Et l'histoire du blanc, moi ça me parle. Parce que je suis libanaise, née au Sénégal. Et pour moi aussi, la robe de mariée est telle qu'on nous l'a
imposée.
C'est pas ça. Parce que les robes traditionnelles partout dans le monde sont très belles. Que ce soit au Sénégal, au Liban, en Asie. Je trouve que cette robe qui est au minimum $250, je ne sais pas combien, on peut faire le tour du monde avec même moins. Je trouve qu'on nous a imposé beaucoup de choses et que nous, on a suivi et qu'on pense que c'est tombé du ciel, hein, que c'est obligatoire, n'est-ce pas? Et quand j'ai parlé avec elle, ben, j'ai trouvé que... C'était ce que je pense en fait. Et mettre autant. Et une plus belle robe, ça ne veut pas dire un meilleur mariage. Non, mais c'est vrai. Ils ne se rendent pas compte, les jeunettes là. Elles veulent des robes à des prix de fou. Donc, il vaut mieux avoir acheté quelque chose pour sa maison. Et puis, si les invités sont sympathiques, ils vont vous trouver belle malgré tout.
People always feel there's someone else trying to, there's someone else's newness, but it's nothing like that. Yes. It's you. Yes. You have to slow down your own ego.
Yes.
Let it go so you can.
So you heard music or read a big, beautiful book, or to go to swim, or to walk.
It's true. To swim, to walk, or to just sit and contemplate.
But it is difficult to contemplate. Because so many comment on dit les pensées?
Thoughts.
I have many thoughts in my head.
Bonjour.
Bonjour madame, vous allez bien?
Alors, vous
allez? Pas encore, d'ici le 23, comme ça je vous dirai. Je vais monter vous dire, merci.
Tu veux que tu vas chicken? Tu veux? Tu veux? Tu veux? Tu veux?
Ok, au revoir, hein. Et bon courage, hein. So you just made a lot of money having a billionaire buying your painting. Now we are alive, so now she's gone, you know. So tell us what's going on.
I just met a very spirited soul. Generally, I don't like to think about my work as a sellable thing, but I think it's she's very open to just, you know, sharing herself with me. I'm open to sharing parts of myself with her, and I think it's a good way to engage in trading something, you know, not just trading money. She's also invited me to come to La Paz and work from her home, which is nice. So we'll see what happens the next few months.
But what is really powerful is when you see a person who's touched by your work so strongly.
It is. I mean, she's lost her husband very recently, and my mother lost her husband when she was very young. And I think I can identify her pain. I can see her pain. We went through the same moment in life, and I'm open to engage in conversation with her. And she shares my mother's name. So it's interesting.
What's her name?
Is Hannah. My mother's name is Hannah as well. So it was kind of like meant. Feels like meant to be in a way. Feels like even if nothing happens, this is me having lunch at her home. She talking to me. Me talking to her.
Is it her car there going?
No.
Okay.
She's okay. In her little shop there. Did you see that shop?
Ah, sure. Okay.
She has that little shop where she sells stuff from. Well, she owns the building, right? Where she built it with her husband. But her husband also has like a construction business, and she has a design business. So whenever they build something for someone, they also design it. So she kind of, it's almost like a complementary to her husband's business.
Do you feel now that more than when the exhibition started, that the piece you made was like for kind of her, or do you think that you think at that level, or it's just too much?
Looking or searching for something, and I think for someone like her, it also signifies a sort of a kind of like, it feels like she can see some, she can identify herself in the piece. And like when I was doing the piece, it was an energy that I was trying to bring across, and she can feel it. So I guess it was for someone like her.
But I mean, I'm very shocked by. In Dakar, you don't expect.
No.
this?
Yes, I also did not expect it. I was in the, I think it was the opening day, I think it was the opening of the Biennale, and she came in with her little granddaughter, Mia, and we started talking, and I explained a little bit of the work, and she said, oh, this is a really nice piece, give me your email address, and I gave her my email address, but with no expectations of ever seeing her again. And then I see her 2 days later, she comes into the bay. She left a little card at the Biennale, actually, with this, one of the securities. I also didn't pick up there, but she sent me an email, and I came to her home, and she just opened up, and she's been opening up. She seems like she, I mean, to a certain degree, she's someone who wants to buy something. And I can see her like that, but I also see her as like a human being. I meet her in a car. It's an insolent, very unique, completely out of my control type of situation, and I'm enjoying it for what it is.
Yeah. Okay, where are you going now?
I'm going to go nowhere.
Okay, let's go. Let's go.